Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the senior high portion of tonight's concert. My name is Zachary Gibbs, and I serve as the chorus president, and I'm also a member of Choral Ensemble. I'm extremely happy to welcome you to our spring concert. Our first selection this evening is Crowded Table, and features two incredibly talented violinists, Logan Ling and Anthony Connect. Our featured vocalists are Ariah Beach, Miranda Cornell, Aiden DeFebo, and Owen DeFebo. Enjoy.
My name is Maria Petrosky, and I am co-vice president of the Senior High Chorus and a member of Choral Ensemble. Our next song is entitled Speechless and features three different voicings for the females in our choir. The song was chosen and voted on by all the members of the choir. We hope that you will be able to hear and see the part singing in this lovely song.
Hi, I'm Aiden Efebo, co-treasurer of the Senior High Chorus and a member of Choral Ensemble. Emerald Stream is an a cappella piece, meaning without accompaniment, written by Seth Houston. Houston composed this piece on his 17th birthday while paddling a canoe. The music that would become Emerald Stream flowed to the rhythm of his paddle. Traditionally, the melody or the main tune is in the soprano line, but this song highlights the basses. So listen for the low sounds of the bass part during the song about environmental stewardship.
Come now and gather in the glade where the emerald stream and the evening shade and meditate on the works he's made, great God, our sovereign Lord. Join us now, the meadow is green and the water's pure and the woods serene and the flowing air is fresh and clean where God his blessings pour.
Feel the wind come down,
feel the wind come down, hear a whistle.
Hi, I'm Logan Ling, co-vice president of the Senior High Chorus and a member of Choral Ensemble. The writer of the next song, Merle Travis, wrote songs about the lives and exploitation of American coal miners. 16 tons refers to a practice of initiating new miners by making them haul 16 instead of the usual 8 to 10 tons per day a miner in the mid-1920s tended to haul. Aside from the exhaustive nature of the job, it proved to be quite risky as well. The pay was terrible. And one line in the song says that the poor miner can't afford to die because he owes too much money to the company store. Even though the message is bleak, the tune is quite catchy. The boys of the chorus enjoy learning this song about the life of a coal miner, which holds special significance to our beautiful county. I want to take this moment to honor the men and women that volunteered their time and effort to rescue the Kew Creek miners. Please enjoy.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in depth.
St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Do, 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 do.
I was born one night when the sun didn't shine. I picked up a shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 times. I dumped that coal in the straw box set.
You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Do, 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 do. If you see me coming better, step aside. A lot of men did it, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel.
If the right one don't get you, then the left one will.
You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Hi, I'm Josie Dorenzo, and I'm a member of the Choral Ensemble. Our next song is Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. It's a throwback to our time singing with masks on during COVID. As we sang this through our masks, it was apparent that we could never do this beautiful song justice until the masks came off. It's so wonderful to once again be able to sing it loud and proud and give it the honor it deserves. Amazing Grace is a beautiful hymn in its own right, but the addition of another melody gives it a strength and purpose it does not have on its own.
Lord has promised good to me.
He's heard my heart's in God.
He will, he will. Hi, I'm Ashlyn Bittner, co-treasurer of the Senior High Chorus and a member of Choral Ensemble. Four Chords is a song we started practicing before COVID, but never had a chance to perform it in a concert. It is a mashup of 24 different popular songs and one old song. Before you get nervous about how long this song is actually going to be, the truth is, if you cough, you might miss one. See if you can count them up and find the one song that does not belong in with all these popular hits. We're going to ask you at the end, no pressure.
Don't Stop Believing, My Journey.
Now, not so fast. No, a lot of songs are the same four chords.
Really?
One, five, six minor, four. My life is brilliant. My life is pure. I saw an angel. Of that I'm sure. People killing, people dying. Children hurting.
Before we start the senior song, I have a few presentations to make. And when I say a few, I've never had this many seniors graduating. I have 17. So I'm sorry, it's going to take a minute. Did you figure out the song? What about Auld Lang Syne? Or maybe Country Roads. I don't know. However you look at it. Okay. So I have some helpers. They're getting some things for me. What I would like to do right now is I would like to announce the senior. And I would like to tell you how long they've been in chorus. There's some other stats about them that I thought were kind of important. Some of these kids have worked super duper hard to get to places like county, district, and regional choir. And I think that needs to be noted because they work all year and they really, really have done a great job tuning their ears and knowing how to sing that upper level music. The blend in this choir is especially strong. I usually don't have so many boys. So I'm very, very proud of all of them because I know it's tough. It's tough to memorize all this stuff and to get the parts right and to sing out. So I really feel like they've done a super job. So thank you. Okay, so as I announce their names, I'm going to give a couple stats about them, and we have a little gift for them. Girls, are we ready? Do we have all that? Okay, you could even bring them out here on the... Okay, so first I'm going to call up Brittany Beal. She's been in chorus 5 years. So Brittany, oh goodness, put them on the... Just put them down here because they have names on them. Start with the one with 10 in it. Okay. Okay, so the next one on my list is Ashlyn Bittner. She's been in chorus 7 years. Ensemble, 2. She was the treasurer of chorus for 1 year. She was in 4 musicals. She went to county chorus 2 years, district 1 year, and regional chorus 1 year. So quite a long history of good work. Okay, I want you to stay up here. Did you give her bag? Okay, and come on down, Ashlyn, I know. Okay, you okay? All right, just stay down here for a minute. Zach Baborchak, because we're going into the senior song, so you might as well just stay here. Okay, Zach Baborchak's been in chorus 7 years, ensemble 3 years. Musical 4 years. County chorus 4 years, districts 3 years, and regions 1 year. So, wow, good job. Akasha Brandt has been in chorus 3 years. Come on down, Akasha. Okay. I taught them to act, so... Sometimes they go a little overboard. All right, Miranda Cornell is next. She was in chorus 7 years, ensemble 2, musical 4, county chorus 2 years, and she was the secretary of chorus 1 year. Okay, next is Josie Dorenzo. She was in chorus 7 years, ensemble 2 years, musical 5 years. Secretary of Chorus 2 years, County Chorus 2 years, District Chorus 2 years, and Regions 1. Whew, that's a lot. Zach Gibbs, or we refer to him as Gibby. Gibby was in chorus for 7 years, ensemble 3. Musical 5, county chorus 3 years, and districts twice. Good job. Okay, next is Karen Hamer. She's been in chorus 7 years. She has been... She's not one to go and perform, but boy, talk about being your back... stage person who helps with everything. Karen, I'm gonna miss you because you just are like my right arm. So that's a tough one. Okay, they're all tough. I don't know. It's crazy. Next is Leah Holland. She was in chorus 7 years, and she was the librarian of chorus 1 year. So can we squish together a little more so we fit everybody on? It's a lot of people. Oh my gosh. Never said this goodbye to this many at once. Logan Ling. Logan discovered chorus a little bit later. He's been with us 4 years, but he's done a fabulous job. He was in musical 3 years, ensemble 2 years. He was in the crew for the first musical that he was in, but he was in 3 musicals on stage. He went to county chorus 1 year, districts 2, and regions 2, and he was vice president of the chorus 2 years. And he plays a mean violin. Okay, I don't think Liz is with us tonight, is she? Okay, she was sick today. So Liz Murbach, I believe she's been in chorus 7 years, and she was in musical, I think, 2 years. So that's Liz. She's not here tonight. She's not with us. Chloe Miller. Come on down, Chloe. As I was working on my stats, I didn't see Chloe that day, so I think you've been in chorus 7 years, am I right? Yes, and you were in musical how many? 3, okay, so fantastic. Okay, next is Brandy Lynn Mowry. She has not been at Somerset long, but she was in chorus at her other school as well, so she has 6 years of being in chorus, and we wish you could have been here longer. Okay, next is Maria Petrosky. She's been in chorus 7 years, ensemble 2 years, musical 5 years, county chorus 2 years. She was vice president of the chorus 1 year and secretary 1 year. And I also need to say, since I'm on Maria, Maria, Josie, and Ashlyn are my three that come and hang out with me during my prep, and they do stuff like the PowerPoint tonight. They worked on that. They made sure that the seniors submitted, which is difficult sometimes. I'm not going to name any names, to get people to submit things. I didn't look at Gibby. I didn't. Okay. Next. Krista Spielman. Krista, come on down. Krista has been with me since sixth grade. She's been in chorus for 7 years. Okay, Nevaeh Upton is next. She's been in chorus 7 years, and she was in musical 2 years. And she's there are a lot of these people that are in other ensembles as well. She's one that's in orchestra as well. Nick Walker. I think Nick is last. Okay, Nick has been in chorus 6 years and in musical 3 years. Do we have everybody? Did I miss anyone? I'm notorious for missing somebody. Oh, and also, I don't know how this happened because I checked, I don't know how many times, but I always end up missing names somehow. And this time it was sisters. Kaya Rogers and, yes, she wasn't on the program. I don't know why. And Maylee Joyce. So, sorry. I often tell the kids that once I get a program exactly right, I'm going to retire. That's it. Okay, so we have a lovely senior song for you all, and I don't know if I brought my, where are my lightsabers? Did we bring them over? Did we bring the lightsabers from the other room? Did somebody bring them? Oh, we have one. Okay, I was told that we weren't supposed to forget that today is May the 4th be with you. So I did have, do you, okay. So we're going to use these. People in the last row, you're going to get some lightsabers that we're going to use during the senior song. I don't know where they went. Okay, they're in a paper bag. I don't know where they went. My husband brought them because I left them at home today. Okay, so who's speaking before this one? Okay, go ahead, get to the mic. You want this? Hey, Zach, do you want this one?
TED Talk one, yes. All right. Hi, my name is Zach Baborchak, and I'm a member of the Choral Ensemble. Today we're doing Back Home. It is a song that was chosen by the majority of the seniors in chorus. In past years, most of the seniors have picked like very slow and somber songs, but this year we wanted to end it off on a more, on a high note, you know? We wanted it to be as upbeat as possible. So this song is a pleasant reminder that we will always have a place to go in... Wow, I wrote this and I can't even read it. It's a pleasant reminder that we will always have a place to go home to in Somerset. Wow, that's a lot of twos. Okay.
Okay, and I'm moving myself back there. Hopefully we'll find the lightsabers. Someone will find them. If not, may the fourth be with you. Adam! Woo! Okay. Say enough wonderful things about this group of people up here. It is, I see my junior high students leaving. Good. Come around. They have to be up here in a minute. Before we start our last number, I just want to say to all of you that are up here, I will miss you. I will miss your faces every day. I know we still have 18 days to go, but that still isn't 17. Sorry. 17. I was corrected. Today was 18. I just can't believe that you're this old. I know parents say that all the time, but I can't. This group has been with me since they were this big, and I'm so proud of all of you. So, so proud. And I hope that you know that you've made a huge impression on the people behind you and on me. So, parents, thank you for raising such fabulous children who can sing. That's great. Love it. I'm hoping that the junior high is headed in. We have a PowerPoint that shows you the seniors while we're singing Like an Eagle. Who's supposed to speak before that? Miranda? Yes. Okay. All right. I'll get the junior high kids in and you can talk.
During our final selection, Like an Eagle, our unofficial Somerset song, we'll be inviting the junior high chorus and any members of the audience who knows the song to join us as we honor our seniors with a special PowerPoint.
Eden Hinton is in seventh grade, and she is playing the accompaniment to this song. It is not easy. I'm very proud of her. It's hard to do this. So as a seventh grader, this is wonderful. I'm going to put my microphone down somewhere here.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for being here. Have a lovely evening. Good night.
Thank you.
Sorry for the false alarm. We just have one quick thank you. We just want to thank Mrs. D for always getting us here and helping us feel prepared and to just teach us what we love to do. So we just thank her for all that she does.
We also want to thank Spencer, who stepped on to do all of our sound, crew, and lighting. This show wouldn't run without you, so we're so thankful for you, and we have candy for you. Okay, that's a wrap.